गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट, माई सेल्फ बीना त्रिपाठी, आई एम योर एसिस्ट टीचर। वेलकम टू द न्यू एकेडमिक ईयर ऑनलाइन क्लास। दिस इज़ योर ज्योग्राफी टेक्सट बुक स्टैंडर्ड 8। स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू एक्सप्लेन यू ज्योग्राफी चैप्टर सेकेंड, दैट इज इंटीरियर ऑफ द अर्थ। इन दिस वीडियो वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न सेकेंड चैप्टर, इंटीरियर ऑफ द अर्थ मीन्स इनसाइड ऑफ द अर्थ। In which planet we are living on that planet? What is inside on the earth? That you are going to learn in this chapter. And you all know that we are living in the earth planet. So let's recall, in the previous classes you have been introduced to rock types, volcanoes and earthquake. Answer the following question on the basis of that. When earthquake occur, what happens exactly? See the students, when earthquake occurs, what happens? Building collapse and there is loss of life and property. Transportation routes are badly affected. Communication system is disrupted. Cracks or fractures develop on the ground. All these are happens when earthquakes occur. How are igneous rocks formed? You know, student, when the molten material known as magma within the crust and the lava on the surface cools down, it solidifies, giving rise to igneous rocks. What is a volcano? A volcano is an opening in the surface of the earth out of which melted rock and gases explode. Which material comes out during a volcanic eruption? Lava, ashes. So all these materials are come out. In which state of matters are this material? So student, these materials are in solid, semi-liquid and gaseous state. And are these materials cool or hot? Why? That means these materials are very hot because the temperature of the earth's interior is very high. So all this we discuss, that all this question answer we are getting in this chapter only. When we are explaining that, you get all the answers. See the students, try this activity is given here. It is very important to you and that means you should learn about that. Boil a half liter of milk. When the milk comes to a boil, switch off the gas, keep a lid on the vessel. The latter part of the experiment is very important. You have to use your observational skill and arrive at some conclusion. After 10 minutes, remove the lid, take it to a side and tilt it. Observe what happens. What can you see on the milk? In what form do you see the layer of the matters on the milk? Remove this layer of matters. Take a note of the difference in temperature of this matters and the milk and the answer the following question. See the student in your home daily your mother boiling the milk. After boiling the milk, we switch off the gas. We all know that. And keep a lid on the vessel. Lid means cover. So latter part of the experiment is very important. See that after 10 minutes what happened, that everything we are learned about how the creamy layer was developed through the milk. So that take it to a side, tilt it means to move or shift so as to learn. So these questions are given below here, that let's we discuss about that. There is given a geography or expression, we can learn everything. When the milk was kept for boiling, in which state was it? So see the student, is in a liquid state. When the milk was boiling, what did you observe? That means we observe that after it came to boil, steam started coming out from it. After some time, a thick layer of cream develop, means malai develop over the milk that we are observing. And what had accumulated over the lid of the vessel? Water droplets had accumulated over the lid of the vessel. Tell whether the matters accumulated on the milk is it liquid or solid. So see the students, what are the matters that accumulated on the milk is in a solid state. Was it cooler or hotter than the milk? The temperature of the cream was cooler than the milk. On which other substance can similar experiment be carried out? See the student, you can do experiment just similarly like you can prepare a dal, preparing dal after dal is fully prepared. Left for some time, a thin layer develops on it. This layer is comparatively less hot than the dal which is in a liquid state. So this way we can get the, through the experiment we are getting the knowledge. Geographical explanation. Before boiling, the milk was in the liquid state. After it came to boil, steam started coming out from it. After some time, a thick layer of cream developed over the milk. The temperature of the cream is lesser than the milk below. Thus, it can be implied that the creamy layer cooled faster than the milk below it, which remained hot and in a liquid form. A similar process occurred when the earth cooled. See the student, with the help of this experiment, what we learn here? That means before boiling, the milk is in a liquid state. After that, when we boil, that steam started coming out, and after some time, what we observe that in the milk, a thick layer of the cream, that is malai, develop over the milk, and we all know that the temperature of the milk, that is the cream, is lesser than the milk below. Why? Because the cream we are seeing the upper surface, and the milk which are in the below, that is we are learning the difference on that, and this way. Thus, it can be implied over the creamy layer cooled faster than the milk below it. And this way, because upper surface creamy layer was, it is cooled faster than the milk below in it, which remained hot and in a liquid form. Same process, similar process we occurred on the earth also. Earth cooled. With the help of this experiment, we learn this. Outer surface of the earth is cooler, but inner part when you go inside, there is a very hot, or there is a heat was increasing day by day. The scientists unanimously, means being of one mind or without opposition, we can say about that, believe that the earth was formed out of the solar system itself. Initially, earth was a gaseous hot balloon. It cooled down as it rotated around itself. The process of cooling took place from the outer surface towards the earth's center. As a result, the outer layer, that is crust of the earth, becomes cooler and solid. But as we move from the surface to the core, heat increases, and at a certain depth, the interior of the earth is semi-liquid. See that student, earth rotates around itself. And we have learned about that earth was a gaseous hot balloon, and it cooled down as it rotated around itself. And we all know that upper surface we are living, it is cool climate, but inner part it is not like that. The difference are there. That means as a result, the outer layer crust of the earth becomes cooler and solid, but as we move from the surface to the core, heat increases, and at a certain depth, the interior of the earth is a semi-liquid form. It has always been interesting, means curious to know about that, about what lies in the interior of the earth. That means we are seeing about that upper surface of the earth, we are seeing about that, but inner part we can't see that, and that's why man has always been showing the curiosity about that, what is in the interior of the earth. A direct observation of the earth's interior has not been possible. That means directly we can't observe that. And through these various methods, the scientists have tried to estimate अबाउट द सेम. एस्टिमेट मीन्स टू जज और टू अप्रोक्सीमेटली वी कैन से अबाउट दैट. टू इन्फर अबाउट दिस स्टडी ऑफ द मटेरियल. कमिंग आउट ऑफ अ वॉल्केनिक इरप्शन एंड द सेस्मिक वेव्स इज मोस्ट इम्पॉर्टेंट. एंड दिस वे वी लर्न अबाउट द हाउ द स्टडी मटेरियल कमिंग आउट ऑफ द वॉल्केनिक इरप्शन ड्यूरिंग द वॉल्केनो एंड हाउ द सेस्मिक वेव्स इज मोस्ट इम्पॉर्टेंट. Matters coming out of volcanic eruption consist of hot magma, gases, steam, etc. Remember, during the volcanic eruption, what is coming out from the earth? Hot magma, gases, steam. When lava cools and solidifies, igneous rocks are formed. See, the students, this question are given that we discuss about that, how the igneous rocks are formed. That means, during the volcanic eruption, consist of when hot magma, gases, steams are coming out and that lava cools and solidifies. And from this solid hot rocks are formed. That is, we can say the igneous rocks are formed. Through the estimates of study of temperature density, gravitational force and the pressure, the interior of the earth was understood. And this way we can understood about that. For instance, when we go deep into a mine, we feel an increase in temperature. That means, in the mining, we can mining that mining time. What happened when we go deep into the mine? We feel that temperature started to increasing. And similar, the magma coming out of volcanic from the earth's interior is hot. Such estimation were made by the geologist. Several earthquakes occur in various places of the earth every year, and seismic waves are generated. These waves travel through the interior of the earth. See the student, what we learn about here, that mining activity, what happens when we go deep into a mine, what we feel that the temperature started to increasing. But same things we are not observed in the upper part of the earth. Upper part cool climate, but inner part when you will go that, you are feeling the temperature will be increasing. And similarly, same process, the magma coming out of the volcano from the earth's interior, means volcanic are coming out with help of the earth interior, is hot. And such estimation were made by the geologist. And we all know that several earthquakes occur in various places of the earth every year. Every year volcanic eruption took place, or earthquake occur also various places on the earth. And on that time, seismic waves are generated, and these waves travel through the interior of the earth. The study of their direction and velocity help us to estimate about the interior of the earth. Man has also tried to dig deep boreholes in the interior to know more about the sea. And this way, man are started to try that, to dig a deep boreholes in the interior to know more about the same, how the temperature was increasing when we go inside. And Sira, do you know, it is also very important, our earth was formed approximately 4.6 billion years ago. Initially, the earth was in a gaseous state. It started cooling through the process of radiation. The earth then liquefied. With time, the outermost part of the earth cooled first and became solid. This outermost layer of the earth is called the crust. Even today, outer planet of the solar system are in a gaseous state. So you should know about that, our earth formed approximately 4.6 billion years ago, and the earth was in a gaseous state. It started cooling through the process of radiation. Afterward, the earth then liquefied, and with time, the outermost part of the earth cooled first and became solid. And this outermost layer of the earth is called the crust. So all this, it is very, very important. Now see that the composition of the earth's interior. Here also that experiment is given here. Carry out the following activity by dividing the students into two groups. Use a picture on the back cover for reference. See, this is also one type of activity is given here. Student, take clay balls of three colors, red, yellow, and blue, that is available in the market. You are getting the market easily. Make the red ball bigger. Roll out the yellow color ball. You will get a flat roti like structure. Place the red color ball inside the yellow one, like you fill puran in a puran poli. Give it the shape of a spear. Now roll out on the blue ball and fill the yellow one in it as done earlier. Make a spear out of this too. And sew the continent in yellow on this spear like a globe. Now your globe made from clay is ready. To see the interior of the earth, cut the spear exactly in half. You can see various layer of color inside, like the layer of the earth's interior. Name this layers. See the student steps in the process of knowing the interior of the earth. That means what we learn about, there are some steps are given, total 12, that means total 14 steps are here. In first step we learn about that, how that clay we have to take that three colors, red, yellow and blue. Afterward we can roll that red ball. Afterwards, so in fourth step we can substitute, take the yellow also and make that yellow flat like structures. Afterwards, see the fifth step we learn about how that red ball was covered by the yellow. And in seventh step, that red and yellow both are covered, it become like circular shape, round shape. And in eighth step, again you have to make the blue color just like flat roti structures. And ninth step, again yellow we can put inside just like puran in the puran poli. 10th step, see that how all three color was come in the one. 11th step, see that after 12 make that some data, see the pictures. Afterward, 13th step, it cut. And what we learn in the 14th step, red, yellow and blue. And the same structure we have learned about the in the earth interior of the step in the process of knowing the interior of the. It is also one type of activity. Okay, student, you can do that. You can easily do in your home. You can understand clear cut. The steps are given here. You can easily learn that. Okay. Students, so you have done the experiment. With the help of the experiment, you will learn about that diagram showing the structures of the earth's interior. So how you can done the experiment, with the help of that you can learn about that, how the red color, yellow and blue, how when we cut out how the three colors we shown into the earth. The same way this picture also we are seeing about that, while going from the earth's surface to its core, major changes occur in temperature and density. With respect to these two elements, the earth interior can be divided into following layers. So see the student, how the layers of the interior of the earth, it was divided in three parts: crust, mantle and core. Crust is divided into two parts, which are the continental crust and oceanic crust. Mantle divided two parts, upper mantle and lower mantle. And core also divided two part, outer core and inner core. See the pictures, structure of the earth interior, inner core, red color is showing about that, outer core and mantle, and crust, continental crust and oceanic crust. See the student, crust, the uppermost layer of the earth's surface is in solid state and is called the crust. And you should know about the, what is crust. The uppermost layer of the earth's surface is in solid state and is called the crust. The thickness of the crust is not the same everywhere. It is different place. And average it is 30 to 35 kilometer thickness. Average how much of the crust is there? Average 30 to 35 kilometer. The thickness of the crust below the continent is from 16 to 45, and below it is how much? 16 to 45 kilometer, 40 kilometer under the mountains range, and less than 10 kilometer under the ocean. And this would be different place. And you should learn about that, average is 30 to 35 kilometer. See that image showing the earth interior, crust 30 kilometer average, lithosphere, upper mantle. See the mantle, how much kilometer? 2870 kilometer. Lower mantle and a core 3471 kilometer. ऐसे द लिथोस्फियर क्रस्ट है मेंटल लिथोस्फियर 100 किलोमीटर, मेंटल इन सॉलिड फॉर्म, आउटर कोर लिक्विड, इनर कोर लिक्विड एंड द अर्थ सेंटर दैट इज 6371 किलोमीटर. द इमेज शोइंग अर्थ इंटीरियर, इट इज पिक्चर ऑफ द अर्थ इंटीरियर. एज वी मूव डीपर अंडर द सर्फेस टेम्परेचर इंक्रीजेस. यस, वैन यू कैन मूव द डीपर वी कैन वॉट वी लर्न अबाउट दैट द टेम्परेचर वॉज इंक्रीजिंग. आफ्टर दैट द रेट ऑफ इंक्रीज इन टेम्परेचर रिड्यूस एंड अगेन इंक्रीज इन द कोर प्लेस. एंड एट द सेंटर ऑफ द अर्थ द टेम्परेचर इज अबाउट, दैट मीन्स द टेम्परेचर इज अराउंड 5500 डिग्री सेल्सियस टू 6000 डिग्री सेल्सियस. सो दिस वे टेम्परेचर वॉज इंक्रीजिंग वेरी लार्ज स्केल. द क्रस्ट इज द थिनेस्ट ऑफ ऑल द लेयर्स. वेन कंपेयर टू द मेंटल एंड द कोर इट कैन बी डिवाइडेड टू टू सब लेयर. विच आर टू सब लेयर्स आर देयर, दैट इज कॉन्टिनेंटल क्रस्ट एंड ओशनिक क्रस्ट. सी द स्टूडेंट, कॉन्टिनेंटल क्रस्ट दैट इज इट इज अबोव द वाटर सर्फेस. कॉन्टिनेंटल क्रस्ट अबोव द वाटर सर्फेस. द कॉन्टिनेंट आर मेनली कंपोज ऑफ सिलिका. सिलिका इज द कंपाउंड ऑफ सिलिकॉन एलिमेंट्स एंड एल्यूमिनियम. एंड बिकॉज ऑफ देयर हाई प्रपोर्शन इन दिस लेयर, द लेयर वॉज अर्लियर नोन एज सी आर. सी आर मीन्स वॉट, इट इज एलिमेंट्स सिलिका एंड एल्यूमिनियम. द डेंसिटी ऑफ द कॉन्टिनेंटल क्रस्ट इज 2.65 to 2.90 gram per cubic centimeter. And the thickness of this layer is approximately 30 kilometer. And in this layer, we are see about that granite rocks are mainly found in this layer. So this is a continental crust. See the student, oceanic crust. This is a second, means oceanic crust below the water surface. Second layer of the crust, it is made of silica and magnesium. In continental, what we learn about that? Silica and aluminium. But in the oceanic crust, it is made up of silica and magnesium. It was earlier called SIMA. SIMA, SI means silica and MF magnesium. And that's why we can say it is earlier called a SIMA. And this, see student, that this layer is approximately 7 to 10 kilometer thick. The density of this layer is 2.9 gram cubic centimeter to 3.3 gram cubic centimeter. In this layer, basalt and gabbro rocks are mainly found in oceanic crust. See that, always remember, elements found in various layer of the earth interior. See the density is given that low to high. And silicon Si, aluminium Al, silicon Si, magnesium Mg, nickel Ni, ferrous iron Fe. These all the elements are there. Now, do you know there is a discontinuity between the continental crust and the oceanic crust? It was first deduced by a scientist called Conrad and is named after him as Conrad discontinuity. So it was first deduced by the scientist called Conrad, and afterward the name is become the Conrad discontinuity. There is a discontinuity between the crust and the mantle too. This discontinuity was deduced by a scientist called Mohorovicic, is has been named after him as Moho discontinuity. There is a discontinuity between the mantle and core too. It has been named as a Gutenberg, a scientist who discovered it. So this we learn about the how they are. They make the reduce and their name are also given different. Okay, now see the student, mantle. Mantle means below the crust lies the mantle. Mantle can again divide it two part, two layer, which are they? Upper and lower mantle. The upper layer is more in a liquid state. And here one find a magma chamber. It is through this chamber that magma comes out on the earth surface during volcanic eruption. And see the student, that mantle divided two layer, which are the upper and lower mantle. And the upper layer is more in liquid state, and here one find a magma chamber. It is through this chamber that magma comes out on the earth surface. That is because of the lava, hot lava, during volcanic eruptions. Here is also known as asthenosphere. Epicenter of deep-seated earthquakes are usually found here. Epicenters of this deep-seated earthquakes are found here. Mantle begins at a depth of around 42 km from the earth surface. So students should know about that. It begins at the depth around 42 km from the earth surface, and epicenter of deep-seated earthquakes are usually found here only. The internal energy released due to endogenetic movement occurring in this layer is responsible for mountain buildings, rift, volcanic eruption, earthquakes, etc. That means because of the internal energy released due to endogenetic movement, what happened that occurring in this layer is responsible for mountain buildings, rift, volcanic eruptions, earthquakes, etc. In this layer, it is inferred that the temperature at a depth of 2400 to 2900 km depth would be around 2200 degrees Celsius to 2500 degrees Celsius. Here, there is a sudden changes in the structure and density of materials, how that it was changes. It is estimated that this layer extends up to depth of 2870 km. And it was started increasing, and it was extended up to the depth of 2070 km. The average density of this layer is 4.5 gram cubic centimeter, and it increases with depth. Increasing pressure is the reason behind this, and the density of lower mantle is about 5.7 gram centimeter cubic. So that is the difference are there. Deep and deep, if you go that, their temperature was started to increasing, and that we discuss, that we learn in this. Average of the density of this layer is 4.5 gram cubic centimeter. It increases with the depth and increasing pressure. The reason behind this, the density of lower mantle is about 5.7 gram cubic centimeter. Now see the core. Core start from around the depth of about 2900 km from the earth's surface. The part of the earth's interior extending from the mantle up to the center of the earth is the core. And that means when we go deep and deep, the temperature was started to increasing. And here also student that core start from around depth is of about 2900 km from the earth's surface. The part of the earth's interior extending from the mantle up to the center of the earth is the core. The thickness of the core is about how much? 3471 km thickness. This layer can be divided into outer core and inner core. It is divided in how many part? Two layer. Which are they? Outer core and inner core. So now let us see the outer core. Outer core extends from around 2900 km to 5100 km. Again, it was increasing. The secondary waves cannot pass through the core, and they get absorbed in this region. And this way, secondary waves cannot pass, they get absorbed. This has led to the scientists to believe that the core could be liquid or semi-liquid in nature. The primary waves travel through this primary, see that. Secondary waves cannot pass here, but primary waves can travel through this layer, but this their speed reduce when passing through this layer. But when they started to pass here, their speed was started to become less. Reduce means what? Less. The density of the outer core is 9.8 gram cubic centimeter. The temperature of the liquid outer core is around 5000 degree Celsius. So see the students, what we learn here, outer core and inner core. Core divided in two parts. What are they? Outer core and inner core. And in outer core extends from around 2900 km to 5100 km. And in this secondary wave cannot pass through the core. It was absorbed in this region. And primary waves travel through this layer, but their speed reduce. when they're passing through this layer. And you should also learn about that the density of outer core is 9.8 gram cubic centimeter, and the temperature of the liquid outer core is around 5000 degree Celsius. We have learned that the outer core of the Earth's interior is in a liquid state, and the proportion of the iron is more in this layer. How much that iron is very large is can be found in this layer. Vertical currents originate in this liquid layer, and this is another characteristics of this area. That means in this we have found a vertical currents are originated in this liquid layer. The difference between the temperature of the outer and the inner core give rise the vertical currents, and this was because difference was it is different temperature are there outer inner core that rise the vertical currents. The Earth's rotation give them eddy. Eddy means circular motion, and electric currents develop in this spherical eddies of the liquid iron, and thus magnetic field is generated. And this way electric current develop in this spherical means round, that is circular motion, eddies. Eddy means what? Circular. Current develop in this spiral eddies of liquid iron, and thus magnetic field is generated. It is sometimes called a geodynamo too. Geodynamo too means the mechanisms responsible for the generation of the Earth's magnetic field caused by convection and conduction current in the fluid core. This magnetic field of the Earth is functional even outside the Earth's surface for quite a distance. As a result, a cover develops around the Earth because of the magnetic field. The Earth's atmosphere is protected from the solar winds coming from the sun. That means the Earth's atmosphere is protect from the solar winds which are coming from the sun. The magnetic field thus developed around the Earth is called magnetosphere. This is the fifth and an important sphere of the Earth. See the students, Earth magnetic field is generated by the slowly moving liquid part of the iron core. Earth has a north and south magnetic pole. It traps many charge particles from the sun, which protect us from harmful solar radiation. And this way we can say about the Earth's atmosphere is protected from solar winds coming from the sun. Now see the next, inner core. Inner core extends from around 5150 km to the depth of around 6371 km, Earth center. That means inner core is in solid form, and deep it was increased up to the depth around is center core of the Earth is 6371 kilometers Earth center. It is the core of the Earth which is in a solid state. The center of the Earth is in a solid state. The density of this sphere is around 13.3 gram per cubic centimeter, and in this we have major elements are found, that is iron and nickel. These elements are found very large scale, and the density also around 13.3 gram per cubic centimeter. It extends from 5150 kilometer to the depth to around 6371 kilometer. See that there are two diagrams are shown here. A1, how the solar winds, you can see about that Earth magnetosphere, and see the magnetic field, magnetosphere, Earth, and B1 is see that geomagnetic pole and equator. See geographical equator. See the two that one which are dashed, we can see about that it is a geographical axis, which are red in color. We will see about the geomagnetic axis. This is also one diagrams are there. First one is Earth magnetosphere, and second diagram is geomagnetic pole. figure 2.3 A and B earths, A magnet. Student, this diagram also very very important. Can you see that? Practice this diagram also. Elements iron and nickel are found in this layer is called as a knife, as the material in this layer is under extreme pressure. The inner core is in solid state. The temperature here is almost equivalent, means same to the surface temperature of the sun. So see this way how the surface temperature of the sun is very hot. Same way the temperature here is also almost equivalent. That means heat is very large scale. And elements are found here, iron and nickel. We can say this layer is called a knife. And this way, in this, this is where the temperature also, it is equivalent to the temperature here, almost equivalent to the surface temperature of the sun. Now always remember, observe the velocity curves of the given seismic wave. See the left curve in figure A show the velocity of secondary waves, while the curve on the right show primary waves. See the pictures A and B, two diagrams are shown here. And in this, we can observe the velocity curves of the given seismic waves. And there are many changes occurring in the curve of the secondary waves. The curve drawn with the help of the dots show the average velocity of the waves, which are dotted line. It shows the average velocity of the waves. And the curve of the secondary waves seem to have ended around a depth is of 2900 km. It was average. See that 2900 km. Changes are visible even in the curve of the primary waves. The velocity of the primary waves increases according to the depth till 2900 km. That is what is very important are there in this. The velocity of the primary waves increases according to the depth till 2900 km. And the velocity of secondary waves is around 6 to 8 km per second around the boundaries of the outer core, and the curve has stopped there. That means 8 km per second around the boundaries. That place, what happened that the outer core and the curve has stopped there. And these waves do not enter the core. At 2900 km, the velocity is around 12 km/s per second. But when it is enter the core, the velocity reduced to the 8 km/s. See this as shown in the dots curve. On the basis of this curves, and the scientist has to be infer the densities at various depth. See this picture. Okay, that is A. Now see that the density curve of the earth interior shown figure B. Red curve in figure B show the gravitational force, which are red colors are there. It show the gravitational force at various depth. Red color, see that student. And the gravitational force increase at certain depth from the surface and then reduce according to the depth. At the center it is zero, as is visible from the curve. And it is visible. See the curves are shown here. And the gravitational intensity centimeter per second. And observe these figures minutely. Find various discontinuities in the density curve and show them on the figure. So this is always remember. See the students, in this we learn about the A and B. Two diagrams are there. Observe the velocity curve of the given seismic waves. See students, you have to read this lesson twice proper way. And see that exercise is given here. That means tick the right correct options in the box. And afterwards, tell whether right or wrong. Correct the wrong statements. And answer the following. Draw a neat diagram, label them and explain. So all these are the assignments are there. You have to do the homework and read this lesson twice. And I hope that you understood this lesson. Thank you.